a very colorful morning to all my dear students of class 11 of all the three streams, science, commerce and humanities. Once again, I welcome you heartily in my English e-learning class. Hope students, you all are fit and fine with your near and dear ones. Today I am here with you with the topic of debate writing, which is already in your syllabus. Let me tell you all one thing, students, that is due to this pandemic, some of the portions of your syllabus have been deleted by the board. Okay, so here debate writing is included in your syllabus for class 11. So today I will be teaching you what is debate, what is debate writing, what is the format of debate writing, as well as what is the marks division of debate writing. Okay, for the current pattern of question paper which you will be getting as prescribed by the board. 2 months before, students, I have already taught y'all the topic of speech writing. Okay, and there I have told you that in case of speech writing, it will be of 10 marks. The question of speech writing will be of 10 marks. But due to this pandemic, the pattern has changed and the board has given a new prescribed format of question paper. Okay, as well as the marks division also has been amended by the board. So therefore, speech writing as well as debate writing, as per the new pattern prescribed by the CBSE board, we are having it as a question of 5 marks, both speech writing as well as debate writing. You will get questions of speech writing and debate writing in your question paper as 5 marks question. Okay, debate writing comes under part B of the writing section of your curriculum. What is it actually? It is a writing composition based on verbal inputs in 120 to 150 words. It is argumentative in nature. The theme should be contemporary topical issues. One out of two given questions you have to answer. So you will get options of debate writing with that of speech writing. Any one you have to attempt. Either you have to attempt debate writing or you can attempt speech writing. Speech writing, as I have told you, I already taught you earlier. In today's class, I will be telling you what is a debate, what is debate writing, what are the important guidelines you should follow while you will be writing the debate. I will give you the format of debate writing, as well as I will tell you the marking scheme of debate writing. Okay, students, at first I will tell you what is a debate. A debate is also a speech with a different way of presenting its content. All speeches are persuasive in style. The speaker's intention is to convert the audience to his or her own way of thinking on the topic. And while writing a debate, you should remember that your points need to be forceful with examples and data as evidence. Points should not be repeated at all. You can use any tense, but follow the same throughout. You shouldn't mingle with present tense, past tense, or with that of the future. You can write in first person and use expressions such as "in my opinion," "then I believe," This type of expressions you can use while you are writing a debate. And this is absolutely a personal form of writing, and hence you should give your own personal opinions. Is it clear? So students, what is a debate writing? A debate writing is a structural discussion on a debatable topic. It is argumentative or analytical presentation of views. It conveys an opinion or viewpoint convincingly in favor or against a topic. What is the aim of debate? The aim of debate is to convince the opposition that you are right. When the two sides agree on the subject, or when one side's arguments are more convincing than the other side, that is when the debate comes to a conclusion. Okay? So if I tell you what are the debating skills, I can tell you that in a debate, opposing arguments are put forward to argue for opposing viewpoints. Logical consistency, factual accuracy, and some degree of emotional appeal to the audience are elements in debating, where one side often prevails over the other, partly by presenting a superior context or framework of the issue. Now students, in order to write a very good debate, what are the points you should keep in your mind? First, you have to give the introduction, which includes salutation and the topic, including for or against the motion. For example, good morning everyone. Okay, esteemed judges, honorable guests, respected teachers, and my fellow students. Am I right? Then you have to tell your name, that I, so and so, feel honored to have been given the opportunity to speak for or against, and you have to tell the name of the topic. Next point you have to keep in your mind is the body. This is the main paragraph or the body of your answer. Am I right? Always begin with the meaning of the topic or the explanation of the topic in not more than a line. Then the starting or the start with quoting the issues. Now here it is important for you to follow a sequence. It is possible that you have too many points or very few points. When you have a lot of varied points, it is better you choose a few best ones and write a line on each. In case you have a few already, explain them in at least two lines each. And make sure you are clear with your thoughts. Only then you will be able to put them into words unambiguously. Then the next important point you have to keep in your mind is the solution. Solution means for every problem there is a solution. In this paragraph you need to be short and crisp, whereby you are supposed to give a rational and practical solution for all the above problems which you have mentioned in the body part. In case you are not able to figure one out, keep in mind a few general ones. It could involve spreading awareness, campaigns, then stringent laws and their strict implementation, education, etc. Using a quote never hurts. It can be general ones like on working together. Every situation can be faced and solved if there is unity. So here are a few handy ones. Like, wherever there is unity, there is always victory. Then another quote like, unity is strength. Then, united we stand, divided we fall. And many more like this type of quotes you can use, which will not hurt anybody's sentiments. And the last but not the least point you have to keep in mind is the conclusion. This part involves clarification of your statement and stance, along with thanking the audience for being such patient listeners. This paragraph needs to be short and precise. Here also, you could add some glitter to your art piece with some quotes like, "The word impossible itself says, I am possible." So this type of quotes can be used in the last or the conclusion part. Okay? So students, while you will be attempting the question of debate writing, you should keep the following points in mind. That is, before you begin writing, write down all the points, one or two words per point, at the back of your answer sheet or the rough sheet, so that you do not forget the relevant points while writing. This also helps you in maintaining a sequence, which is very important. Make sure you double check for grammatical accuracy and spellings, because they also carry marks. Leave adequate number of lines between paragraphs to make it look clean. Underline the main points, which is very, very important. But it is advised to do it after finishing your exam. Use a pencil and scale for underlining when you will be revising the whole answer sheet. Always have a few general quotes in handy, because they help in presentation and shows that you are prepared. Presentation is very important. Read a lot of debates to get an idea. Have information about all the major environmental, political, social issues that have taken place during the entire year. Okay, go through the last few years question papers or sample papers also. One very, very important debatable topic is social media and its effects. Okay, it can be linked with a lot of problems we are facing today on personal and on global level also. Okay, then another example is spreading of fake information. Okay, then all these type of things. And while you will be attempting the question of debate writing, never mention any of your personal details, that is your name, school or address. Okay, never write in one go. Make sure you follow the right format and make proper paragraphs. Don't use any slangs or short forms. Don't write wrong facts, and you should maintain the word limit as prescribed by the CBSE board, and do not invest too much time in one particular question. Am I right? Okay. Now students, I will be telling you the marking scheme of the debate writing as prescribed by the CBSE in this year. Okay, this debate writing comprises of 5 marks. For the format, you will get 1 mark. For the content, you will get 2 marks. And for expression, you will get 2 marks. So students, with this, I am coming to the end of today's class. And in my next class, I will be giving you a sample of debate writing. Is it clear to y'all? So, you keep your English copies and pens ready with y'all. And if you have any problem regarding this topic of debate writing, you can contact me and clear your doubts. So, thank you, students. For today, bye-bye.